We're down here at Antioch Baptist Church, down here in Harrisburg, Alabama, getting ready to do a groundbreaking ceremony here to Pastor Reverend Terry Bell. We just grateful here. I have one of the great-grands down here with some of the deacons. Her name is Nasia, and one of Bibb County High School basketball players. One gonna be a good one, and so we just glad to be here. Nasia, say hello to him. This is Christine Dorsey. Her dad was George Goree, one of the head deacons down here, big time deacon, prayer leader. And he was talking about this a long time ago, about he was the trustee down there also. And he was talking about this a long time ago about this church and everything. So I'll let Christine talk to you about her dad.
Do you know when the church was first founded?
I really don't, but it's been over 100 years ago. It could be 150 plus. But I know when my dad was here, and if he was living, he'll be 100 years old. So he went here when he was a little boy, and his parents went here, and my mom went here, and her parents. So it goes way back, way back.
I'm blessed to be here with you on today.
Thank you.
I understand the cemetery for the church is on down this road here.
Yes, Perkins Cemetery.
Perkins.
Okay. Okay.
Right. Thank you, Christine.
Thank you too.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Uh-huh.
All right.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Come on and give the Lord a hand clap of praise.
Yeah.
Because he's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same sun, he is worthy.
Yes.
First, giving honor to God, who's the head of our lives, to our pastor, Pastor Bell.
Yes.
To our distinguished guests.
Yes.
We would like to welcome you here today. It says New Antioch Baptist Church groundbreaking program, and that's worth a hand clap of praise in itself.
Yeah.
About 5 years ago, the Lord sent us somebody that promoted unity. He preached unity to us.
All right.
Ooh, about maybe four or five months. He preached unity to us about 4 or 5 months, and he said the Lord had gave him a vision. And he asked us to follow him in that vision.
Mm-hmm.
And lo and behold, we did.
Amen. Amen.
He always told us to look this way, and you can see it coming.
All right.
He kept telling us to look this way.
All right.
And you can see it coming.
Right.
And today, we're starting on the coming of a new building.
Yes. Right.
We thank all of you for taking out your time to come down and be with us.
Yeah.
And we hope that you would come back even for a better occasion, and that's when we get ready to enter our new building.
All right. All right. Yeah.
I pray that you feel welcome when you came up on the grounds. Once again, you're welcome.
Amen.
And now we will have a congregational song. I will trust in the Lord.
Come on now.
Get in the service.
Come on now.
will stay on the battlefield. I'm going to treat everybody right until I die. I will treat everybody right. I will treat everybody right. I will treat everybody right. Till I die, I'm gonna stay on the battlefield.
Say that.
I'm gonna stay on the battlefield. I'm gonna stay on the battlefield until I die.
Until I die. Yes, sir.
Said I'm gonna trust in
yes,
the Lord. Yeah. I'm gonna trust in the Lord. I'm gonna trust in the Lord until I
a scripture by Pastor Thomas Hill Sr., pastor of the Pine Grove Baptist Church, after which we will have an invocation by Pastor Larry Moultrie, pastor of the Pleasant Sabine Baptist Church.
God bless you today.
God bless you.
May he make his face to shine upon you.
Amen.
To our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ.
Come on now.
Our distinguished guest, to all of you that make up this congregation, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Scripture reading today coming from the great book of Psalms, chapter 127, his entirety.
Mm-hmm.
Except the Lord build the house.
Mm-hmm. Come on now.
The labor's in vain that build.
Yeah.
Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman worked, waited, but in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late,
mm-hmm.
to eat the bread of sorrow, for so he giveth his beloved sleep. Lo, children are an inheritance of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. As sorrow are in the hand of a mighty man, arrows in the hand of a mighty man, so are children of the youth.
Mm-hmm.
Happy is the man that has quivered, his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearers, those that do his will.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
One more time.
Amen.
All right, you got to give me one more. Just one more.
Amen. Amen.
Hey, this is a special occasion.
Come on now.
This don't come by often, yes, so sir. We ought to thank God for this moment. Come on, come on, come on.
I know my
assignment today, but on behalf of Pleasant Sabine, well, I'm Pastor Bell, come out of Pleasant Sabine, and I want you to know we did bring you a gift.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. We want to know, we're not only here to support you physically, but we did put a few pecans in there that you can, you know, help you out. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God. Thank God for that. And I'm finna pray, but in the book of Haggai, the first chapter and the fifth verse say, consider thy ways. But if you ran back up in there, the prophet Haggai prophesied to the people. And New Antioch, you considered your ways and listened at the prophet of God. Now give yourself a hand of praise. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you is our prayer. Eternal God, our Father, we come right now, Lord, first to say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for being God and God all by yourself.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord, for you allow visions to come reality. Lord, we thank you now that you have placed a visionary in this vineyard to labor. But most of all, Lord, we thank you for the people who is following him. Thank you for the people who listen at the word of God, listen at the voice of the man, and then they sold into the vision. We thank you now. Lord, we ask you to continue to lead, guide, and strengthen them. Not by might nor by power, but by your spirit. We thank you now for this church. We thank you for this day. Now, Lord, as they go forth, it's going to be many days that they wander, but let them continue to look unto the hills from which cometh they help. Let them continue to rely and depend on you to start and to finish this assignment. And we'll give your name glory and give your name honor.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Lighten up.
We thank Pastor Thomas Hill for that scripture and for Pastor Moultrie for that divine invocation.
Yeah.
Now we're down to another song. It says congregation. That means y'all.
That choir president. I was find that choir president.
Lord, bless his holy name.
Yes, Lord.
Bless his holy name.
It's horsefly. I ain't got my hat. It's a horsefly. That's a horsefly. You got anything? I'm tired. Got a horsefly.
Every prayer. Every word worship.
That's a horsefly biting there.
Every praise. Every praise.
You got it?
To
Yeah.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah. To our God.
I think you can do a little better.
Come on now. Come on, thank you.
And give the Lord the praise that he is due.
Come on now. I'm just sitting down. Don't deal with this now.
Every praise.
Every praise is to our God.
Every word worship.
Every worship. Is what to call.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Is
to our God.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah. To our God.
Glory hallelujah.
Glory hallelujah. To our God.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Is
to our God.
God, my healer.
God, my healer.
God, my deliverer.
God, my deliverer.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
God.
Savior.
God, my healer.
God, my healer.
God, my deliverer.
God, my deliverer.
Yes, he is.
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 Praise every person.
Praise it to my God.
Everyone worship.
Everyone worship. We want to come.
Every prayer.
Every prayer.
Every prayer.
Every prayer.
Is to
my God. All right now.
And this is an occasion to give the Lord all the honor and the praise.
Amen.
Now we're going to turn the rest of this program over to Pastor Bell.
Amen. Amen.
Greetings to all of you.
Greetings.
In the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ.
Amen.
Who is the head of all our lives by creation and by redemption.
Yes, sir.
We count it a blessing just to be here.
Amen. Yes.
We count it a blessing, amen, just to be alive.
Yes. Yes.
This day is a long time coming.
Amen.
Yes.
And to y'all, you ought to be excited today.
Come on now. Come on now.
Is there anybody out here excited more than me?
Come on now. Come on now. Hallelujah. Yes, sir.
Truly, we thank God for you. We thank God for all that's been taking place at this time. To my wife, to all of our special guests, amen. To we have a lot of different special guests on here. We're going to call them up. We want them to come and address us. And on the program we have coming up next is Mr. Tony Lee. He's with the Moundville Bank, Moundville, Alabama.
Amen.
He is the one who is backing us. So that's why I came and put this sign in front of you.
That's right. That's
amen.
Right.
Amen. Amen. So we're thankful for him who is partnering with New Antioch Baptist Church. So I want y'all to give him a warm welcome as he comes to the podium.
Come on now.
Good afternoon.
Afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Amen. We should be excited about what we got going on. Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Now let me tell you a little bit about me. Okay. I am the vice president, senior loan officer with the Bank of Moundville. My responsibilities are to oversee the operation of the loan department. Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
But I'm also a child of God.
All right. Now, come on.
Amen. So see, one thing that Pastor Bell and Deacon Dorsey didn't know when they were dealing with me in the bank is I serve as a deacon in my church, amen?
Amen.
Amen. I'm actually the chairman of our deacon board, amen? And we had a wonderful service this morning, and I left there headed here for this event, amen? And guess what my pastor spoke on coming out of the books of Acts? We're in this thing together, amen?
Yeah. Yes.
Amen? So Antioch, you and the Bank of Moundville are in this thing together.
Amen.
Amen? Amen. So we look forward to working with you. We look forward to having an opportunity to see the project advance. You know, I thank God that we've been blessed to work on a lot of projects like this. And one of my favorite scriptures that I like to often share with a congregation is, the scripture says, to whom much is given, much is required.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
So this is just the start today, you all. Once this project comes out of the ground, once this project is built, then what's important is how you bless the community all with right. the building. Amen. Right. Amen.
Yeah.
It's more than just the building. It's what you do with the building. Amen.
Amen.
So we want to just thank you for the opportunity to be here. Bank of Moundville, we look forward to working with you in this project. You'll see me coming. You'll see me on site. You'll see me coming through and doing different inspections. But most of all, I look forward to the day when we come back and the dedication is done. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So I thank you again, Antioch, for the opportunity. Reverend Bell, I thank you for the invitation to come. Deacon Dorsey, it's been a pleasure working with you. And I look forward to seeing you all as things progress. God bless you.
Amen. God bless
you.
Good job, baby. Good job. Good job.
Thank you, Deacon Lee.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. He did not tell me that. We're grateful for him. We are in this thing together, like he said.
Amen.
Amen. And we're working, we've been working with Mr. Lee for the last 4 years. Pandemic hit, and we gotten through it, and the Lord got us back on track. But we're grateful for him, amen, working with the new Antioch Baptist Church. So we're looking forward to work with him for the next 2 years, amen. Yeah. Next we have Mr. Kirk Littleton, Century Alabama Home Builders, Lawley, Alabama, amen. And his secretary, Ms. Right. Regina, she's gonna come and speak on his.
My name's Regina Latham. I am Kurt Littleton's secretary. This is Chris Gray, our foreman. And Kurt is sorry he cannot be here today, but he sent a letter. So I'll read it in behalf of him. Dear ladies and gentlemen and brothers and sisters in Christ, let me say what an honor it is for the representatives of my company to be with you. Chris Gray will be the foreman of the job, and you will see him quite often. Regina Latham is my secretary and plays a big role in the organization of the different phases of the building of your church. I apologize that I cannot be here today due to having some tests ran in the hospital. I should be out the first of this next week. If the weather allows, we plan on starting the building of the new church this next week. I look forward to working with Pastor Bell and Brother Dorsey to ensure that when we are finished, you will have a church building that everyone can be proud of. Please know that if there are any questions that arise, you may ask my foreman or my secretary, and together we will solve any issue that may arise in the building project. Again, thank you for the privilege of building your church, and it will be our priority to make sure that you have a very beautiful building that will testify to God's glory and his faithfulness. God bless you all as we move forward in this endeavor together to build a very lovely facilities. Sincerely, Kurt Littleton.
Amen.
Thank you for allowing us to be here.
Regina Latham, we talk very often. Amen. Sometimes 2, 3, 4 times a week, we talk often. So again, we look forward, amen, to working with you. Next, we have Brother Rodney Stabler, Bibb County Commissioner. He is also a deacon, amen, at Mount Tabor Baptist Church.
Amen.
So he will come and speak with us as well.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on.
Give honor to God who had my life, to Pastor Bell, all the pastors that I hear, deacons at Antioch. I'm coming today. Pastor Bell come to me around 2 years ago, and he told me that he had a vision. And, well, you know, things is not dead and overnight. It's a progress in everything you do.
Yes, sir.
And also, I talked to him about my vision with the storms and stuff coming through. And 80% of Bibb County, you all know, most of the people is staying in trailer houses. Uh-huh. And my vision is, through the EMA man, Mr. Kurt Smith, I ain't gonna take away from him. He's here to speak to y'all too. And we, y'all know we was hit last year.
That's right.
And it's opened the door for the two sites that we, as administration, we decided on. We're gonna start at Antioch Baptist Church in Ashby Baptist Church in Broadfield.
Amen.
And Pastor, I love that theme you got on your member's shirt. That's one thing, one team, one dream. That's true in everything you do. You got to do something together. Teamwork. It ain't just for the younger kids coming up. Working as a team, when they out playing ball with each other. If y'all look what y'all doing, the day is special. Amen. Y'all breaking ground.
Amen.
On a new building.
Amen. That's right.
That's teamwork.
Amen.
And the deacons that's here at this church, I know them personally. Deacon Dorsey, Deacon Walker. They constantly stayed on me. And every time I seen them, I say, we working on it. I want to let you know, man, whatever. And I want to leave out one person stayed on me too, because she'll call me and she don't care to that. 5 o'clock in the morning, I'm getting up to go to work. Miss Joanne Craig here, all right, she going to let me know it. Hey, we got a vent somewhere. You need to be there. But I thank God for her. She keep me on my toes. But I love doing what I'm doing just for the community, not only District 5, for the whole Bibb County area. And
I'm gonna kill it.
To come together, be reunite with y'all today down here is an honor. And first of all, I want to thank you. I want to thank God for you all. Yes,
sir. Next, we have Mr. Kurt Smith. He is the EMA director of Bibb County. Before he comes, Kurt was one of those I also talked with probably 5 years ago. We talked about a storm shelter. We needed one around this area. And I remember him telling me, said that unless a storm come through here, you'll at least get a shelter then. And he did what he could do, and the storm did come through. Mm-hmm. No lives was taken.
Amen.
This area was chosen for a storm shelter. So y'all put your hands together, Mr. Come on this side, Mr. Kirk.
Thank you so much for having me, Pastor Bell. New Antioch Church, thank you for allowing me to come. This day, I think it's a blessed day. I thank God. Y'all just, like Pastor Bell was talking about, I'm a local pastor myself of Bibb County, I might say something, you know. But I don't know if y'all understand, God's hand was all over this. Yeah. Every bit of it. And there was 285 homes that were damaged March 25th. And out of those 285 homes, 57 destroyed, 54 major, which is pretty much destroyed. 13 miles of debris, and nobody killed. That's God's hand on this county. That's what God is doing in Bibb County. He's taking care of people. Now, Commissioner Stabler, Reverend Bell, I'm going to tell you what, myself, there's been a lot of prayers going on when it came to storm shelters. Commissioner Stabler, I hope you get to maybe shake his hand twice, because really, with, of course, the good Lord's help, but y'all, he worked hard. He come to me over and over again. He says, Kurt, we got to make this happen. And we prayed, and sometimes I just didn't know y'all. I tell Commissioner, I don't know. But you know what? He dug, and he found a way to put this community shelter here at Harrisburg. Amen. Now, I want to tell you something. When Pastor Bell met me, he was parked right there, and I pulled up right there, and I got to looking when I got out, and I saw these stakes. And I'm like, oh, Lord, that storm shelter ain't going to be that big. But I walked over here, and he told me what was taking place, what y'all were getting ready for. And y'all, it excites me as a pastor in Bibb County, Alabama, to see some ground broke for the Lord. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
I'm excited about that. But what I'm even more excited, I know the Bibb County Commission is going to put y'all a storm shelter right over there. Amen. And that's going to keep folks safe for about 2 hours. But what y'all building right here is going to keep folks safe for eternity. Amen. Right here. Amen. The Bible talks about God's house being the temple, a place where you can come and worship. Preach. It's going to be a place where you can come and worship and be in the presence of God. And I'm going to tell you what the Bible tells me. When you're in God's presence and under His wings, ain't no storm going to touch you in His house. Okay? Now, I'm going to tell you what. I'm excited for y'all. I'm looking forward. This ought to build your faith. It has built my faith. God will do. If you'll just pray and have faith, it will work out. One last thing. I think about the houses that God built. He talks about mansions. A mansion is a place with more than enough room to grow. A mansion is enough place where all can come and find rest. You can find what you need. God says, I got plenty. All we got to do is believe that He will provide. I love y'all. I'm praying for y'all. Looking forward to what's going to take place right here. I hope y'all will invite me back when this building is completed.
Amen.
And I thank y'all so much. Keep praying. Keep believing. God is going to take care of us.
Nah. Thank you, Pastor Kirk. A great man of God. Pastor Kirk said something. He said, there must be some praying going on. Antioch, what time do we have corporate prayer? We don't be with each other, but every day at 12 o'clock, we set our alarms on our phone. And whatever we're doing, we're praying for the vision of the house. Again, thank you again. Thank you, Antioch.
Amen.
Next, we have Brother Dunn Mack, City of Centerville Councilman, a great friend of mine, and I knew whenever I called him, I know he wasn't going to say no.
Amen.
I knew he was going to show up. Y'all put your hand together for the Centerville City Councilman.
Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
I would introduce myself, but that would be a disappointment. You know, because if you don't know me by now, you won't never know me. Okay? We just glad to be here. To the pastor here, Pastor Bell. To all the pastors on the right. A lot of us back here talked about the storm shelters. And we talked about it. And we talked about what it was going to be and everything. But let me get this out the way first. Sister White was going to be here. Mayor White was going to be here, but she had another engagement. But she told me to tell y'all, don't feel bad or nothing like that. Just tell your secretary and the treasurer to check the count. Mm-hmm. Do y'all know what that means?
Yes,
okay.
Exactly what it means.
Rev Howard said that he had to be in Hale County, in Greene County. He couldn't make it. He said, but tell a pastor and his member to check the count. Y'all know what that means?
That's good.
So I'm not going to say anything else. All I know is Ralph Howard said, get out and vote. I told him that I am nonpartisan because I'm a city council official. We don't have no Democrat or Republican. We can't say that because it's unethical. But he said, get out and vote.
Uh-huh.
And so I can say, get out and vote.
Yes, sir.
And do that. But let me say my little speech, what I was going to say. Kirk done took part of it, but that's okay. We'll have a talk about that later. But I am so excited that this is happening. Whether y'all realizing or not, that when we was talking about building the church, somebody said you don't have enough people
come on,
to fill that church. What you building a new one for?
Yes, come on.
Why don't you just keep the old one? Well, I studied for a while and I prayed for it, so I had an answer the next time.
All right.
I said, supposing somebody had to say it, come on, y'all, help me out. The Old Testament. Mm-hmm. Won't we just stay in the Old Testament? Is anybody thinking like I'm thinking?
Yeah.
What if we had stayed in the Old Testament? Y'all have thought about that? When you were praying, said, Lord, we want a new church.
Uh-huh.
And somebody said, you don't even feel letting up yet. Why don't y'all fill the old one up first? But you got to realize, if the new don't come, one of them's supposed to testify for the other one, don't it? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So if we don't bring the new one,
I like that.
The old one gonna do what? It's just gonna sit there because the veil ain't gonna be ripped. You gonna have to pay me to pray for you. And you ain't got enough money, I might not pray for you. So if you wanna stay in the old, then you stay on over there. But Antioch and Pastor Bear, we going into what? The new one. And all y'all that want to stay in the old, we'll get at 12 o'clock and we'll do what? We'll pray for you. But we as Antioch and Pastor Bear, we going into the what? The new. So I thought about that and I asked my wife, I said, should I say that? She said, can't nobody say it and put it right but you.
All right.
I said, ain't nobody going to tell, they not going to sit up there and say that. Ain't no preacher going to say that. I said, well, let me say it because I don't have no memories to lose. So I look at that and I think about that. Then I thought about Peter. Mm-hmm. And I thought about the storm shelter.
Yeah.
And then I told Christine about her daddy, Rem Goree, how he would carry that pouch around and take up those building funds donors. Mm-hmm. How many of y'all are building fund donors? Raise your hand. Come on now. And if you're not on the building fund donors, you're in the Old Testament. Because the building fund donors were looking for what? The new. So when the old deacons were carrying those pastors around, he said, all he doing, that suit was swagging, and he just kept saying, it's going to be all right, just keep praying. Now, you are now foreseeing what they had already saw. Old men supposed to do what Rem told them? Don't they supposed to?
Dream dreams?
Okay. Is anybody else catching on to that? This is what we're about today. This is their dream. You got to have one to go further. Because after that, we're looking for a life center. That's your dream. Because it ain't going to be no more schools. Everybody going to go charter. Watch it now.
You're right, sir.
Watch it. Because you got to go forward. And then, on an occasion, Peter said something that made everybody shake. And everybody remember when Jesus asked Jesus? Ask Peter, who do they say I am? What did he say?
Some said Elijah, some said Jeremiah.
Come on. Mm-hmm. He said what now?
Mm-hmm. But
Peter said what?
You are.
Antioch. Yeah. You are. Yeah. The new.
Yeah.
He said, then Jesus said, okay, I know you didn't get that because I know my Father in heaven put that on you. But then, hold on now. He said, here come the new. Them building fund donors, this y'all right here. He said, I build my church on this rock. And the gates of hell, tornadoes, don't need no storm shelters, tornadoes. Ain't nobody, you ever notice when the tornadoes hit these churches all over Alabama? Do you ever hear them say, we ain't gonna build no more? Those building fund donors come in and say, hey, we got to get this thing back up.
Yes, sir.
That's the new. So y'all stay with the new. Now those at old, 12 o'clock, we praying, okay? But I am so excited, and me and Pastor Bell are on several committees together. We on a committee called the Jumpstart Alabama Prison Ministry, where we go down and pray for and teach people that are in the prison that are incarcerated. We on a lot of things, and I do a lot of things. I'm so spread out, I just don't know. I think David Daniels just told me, he said, you the news recorder today, okay? I said, okay, I can do this. But what I'm saying is this. I am so excited.
Yes, sir.
I am too,
Doc. Yes, sir.
The red lets us know that the shirts you got on, the blood is still flowing from all the old deacons. Yes, and that's y'all. Yes. Thank y'all.
Thank you, Brother Mack, City of Samuel Councilman. Also, again, our Mayor Brent, Bobby White, who could not be here. Amen. But she. Her spirit is here with us.
Amen.
She had another engagement, but one for that, she would be here with us.
So that's right.
She's always supportive
Amen.
Of the New Antioch Baptist Church. That's whenever right. we put something on, whenever we decide to get together and God doing something with us, she's always supportive of us. That's so right. again, we thank God for her in her absence. Also, we'd like to thank Brother David Daniels, a great friend of ours from a long time ago. We've been known a long time. He's with the Centerville Press. Amen. So y'all give God some glory for him. Thank God for him coming to be with us and to cover our story. So again, we thank you so much. Amen. Thank you so much. But now we're getting ready for our groundbreaking ceremony. What we're going to do is ask all of our guests to please come up to the shovels. And y'all get ready to take some pictures. We'd like all of our guests to take some pictures with us.
How many shells y'all guests. Got?
Together now.
On
three, I want y'all to say New Antioch.
Okay.
One, two, three. New Antioch.
Right
there. God bless you. Amen. Thank you so much. Amen. Thank you so much. Now I'd like for all my pastors and visiting pastors to come with me. Sister Bell, come with me, please. All my pastors, visiting pastors, come and stand with us. Any pastors?
Pastor.
All the pastors and preachers.
Visiting pastors, come on.
Come and stand with us.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
All right, Mike. Y'all preach.
Amen.
Get over there, Mike. Come on.
Come on in. Just grab your seat. Thank God for being with us.
Come on. All right. Hold on. Hey, Pastor Bell, hold on 1 second. Mm-hmm. Let me get him to come down one shelf. And you get one shelf. Sister, you get one shelf. There you go. Everybody got a shelf. That's all the preachers right there.
On three. One, two, three.
I got you. You know I got you.
Also,
good deacon.
This is the best thing with you. I need all of Antioch deacons. I need Antioch deacons to come with us. All the deacons of Antioch.
Good.
Come on in. Get.
You tell Renee I did good.
Okay.
On three. One, two, three.
Yeah.
All right, thank you.
Yeah. Remember the big trip. Yeah, I work with a husband. Yeah.
There you go.
Well, she thought she was going. You thought she was going home.
Yeah, she thought she was, but
like,
I done said I'm almost there.
Oh, come on, man.
Come on.
You don't have to say it. I'm going to ask the question.
Yeah,
you know. No, I'm not going to do nothing like that.
Really?
You know my wife.
Probably so.
Priscilla works at the bank. Priscilla Mack. That's my wife.
Okay.
Okay. I see. Okay. She better take care of you, bro.
Every praise
to our God,
God my Savior.